Onomatopoeia, onomatopoeia, all I want to be is an onomatopoeia.
Onomatopoeia, a word that imitates the sound. Song, sound, the next figurative language term is alliteration.
I can show you the world. Shining,
shimmering, splendid. Gosh, it disturbs me to see you, Gaston,
looking so down in the dumps.
A simile is when you use the words like or as.
Swift as a coursing river, with all the force of a great typhoon. Strength of a raging fire, mysterious as the dark side of the moon.
I'm just a little black rain cloud hovering up.
So the difference between a simile and a metaphor, again, is a simile says I'm like a lion or I'm as strong as a lion. A metaphor says I was a lion tearing into my dinner. So when you say something is something, it's a metaphor. It doesn't really matter that you know like the specific difference between a metaphor and a simile. Probably if you ask your parents, they wouldn't remember. But to remember to put that into your writing is important, and to understand that that like brings it to life a little bit more. So here's Winnie the Pooh pretending to be a rain cloud.
I'm only a little black rain cloud. Pay no attention to little me.
Life is your restaurant and I'm your maitre d'.
Hyperbole is an exaggerated statement.
He's a fluffy unicorn. He's so fluffy, I'm gonna die.
I'm gonna die. He's not really gonna die.
Regular men, definitely.
He faced the galloping hordes.
100 bad guys with swords.
Personification is when you give something that's not human, human qualities.
Hey princess, now when did you last let your heart decide?
So did you hear that? He said, let your heart decide. Is a heart something that can decide things? Not really. So that was personification. Okay. Let's see, escape full screen. And I have one more thing we're going to play. So now in the chat, let's see if we can find the chat. Everybody find your chat. I'm going to set it so that you can chat to everyone. And I want you to put into the chat, if you can figure it out, what kind of figurative language it is or what you think your answer is. So can you discover the missing picture by answering questions about figurative language? Again, we're going over figurative language and comparing it to literary language. It's on page 3 of lesson 107. You can look at it and you should print that chart and have it handy. If you don't have the chart handy, you might even want to bring the chart up right now. So here we go. We're starting the game. We're going to click on this one and see what the question is. You are a bear in the morning. Is that a simile or a metaphor? Put it in the chat if you have a guess. Simile or a metaphor? Ooh, I see an M for metaphor. Nice. You can just put an M or an S. Good. You guys are good. It is a metaphor because it doesn't say like or as. So let's see if we're right. Ooh, good. So if it's right, you get the picture uncovered. We're trying to solve it. Pretty as a picture. Simile or metaphor? Pretty as a picture. Put in your next guess. Oh, people are saying simile because it's got as in there. Nice. We got to uncover another piece of our picture. Sally sells seashells. Alliteration or onomatopoeia? A or O? Sally sells seashells. I see a lot of A's, a couple of O's. Now remember, alliteration is when something has the same starting sound, Onomatopoeia is when it's a sound word like pam, bow, whack. Oh, I see alliteration now has won. Never mind. All right. The sun sang in the sky. Oh, that's interesting because that is alliteration, but they're not giving us that choice. So the sun saying in the sky, is that a metaphor or personification? Remember, a metaphor is when you say the sun is something else. Personification is if you give the sun human qualities. Oh, I see everybody changed personification. Ooh, we're uncovering this picture. Bang, onomatopoeia or simile? What do you think? Ah, I see a lot of onomatopoeia, which is really fun to say anyway. Boom, good job. I'm hungry, I could eat a horse. Is that hyperbole or personification? H, hyperbole. You're right. You guys are doing this, you're rocking this. Red roses rock. Is that alliteration or a metaphor? I see some A's popping in there. Oh, you're getting really good at this. The dog is a princess. Simile or metaphor? Look at you guys, you are good. I see a lot of M's in there, metaphor. And buzz, hyperbole or onomatopoeia? Oh, I can't trick you, you're experts at this. We're almost done with our picture and I think it's a puppy. You are as ugly as an ogre. Ugly as an ogre. I see metaphor, metaphor, metaphor. Now remember, oh, I see some S's popping in there. A simile has like or as in it. Ah, there we go. Okay, good. The paper screamed. Is that onomatopoeia or personification? I see both guesses, but most people are saying personification. You're right. If it said like, scream the paper, that would be onomatopoeia. Oh, we got a puppy. Well done, folks. All right, I'm going to stop my share. That was my little lesson for today. We don't have a ton of time left today. So remember, tomorrow we're going to have our DBAs. Today you need to go into those lessons and just kind of review those things. If anything I mentioned that I'm going to talk to you about tomorrow seemed hard to you, make sure you know what a theme is. Make sure you know what figurative language is, what a verb is. Make sure you remember the stories about Carolina and her experiences at the coast, where she rescued the lighthouse keeper and rescued the birds and all of those and the shipwreck and all that stuff. So you should know all that stuff. We have after this specials, and then we have our math lesson at 10 o'clock. Make sure you've done your dream box for the day. I'll check in with you guys about that. And then a few kids that I wanted to talk to. So I'll let the rest of you, if you want to, go into breakout rooms for about 5 minutes and check in with each other. But I'd like these kids to stay with me. Anna, Sophia, Amoy, Lauren, and Dalmir, if you could. And also, I just wanted to check really quickly my attendance list and see who I've got. I've got 17 kids today. And if I ever make a mistake on attendance, let me know, okay? All right, I don't see, let's see, is Luis here? Nope. Let me just check my attendance really quickly so I don't mess up. I don't see Dalmir. If you're here, speak up. I don't see Luis. So if there are 17 of you and there's 23 in our class, then there's 6 kids missing. So who are the other ones missing? We've got, Javier's here. Amadi, are you here? Yes. Eli's here. Anna's here. Sophia is here. Yes. Yes. Bree's here. Liam is gone. He's excused. Amoy's here. David's not here. Halime's here. Nora is here. Yes. Jax, I think I saw you here. Are you here? Yes. Good. Lauren is here, Christian's here, Kainoa's here, Evie is here, is Mila here? Yes. Megan's here, and Sasha's here. I'm not really missing that many kids. Why is it showing kids missing? Phoebe's here. That's weird. Izzy is not here. Is Izzy here? H-I. Izzy is gone. Okay. Well, that's weird. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 kids gone. 5 and 17 makes 22. So who am I missing? That's weird. I don't know who else I'm missing. I'm missing one more kid, but I don't know who. So I'm going to open up breakout rooms. You can go to the breakout rooms unless you're one of the kids that I asked to stay here. I'm just going to set up about 5 breakout rooms or 4. So you can go there and I'll let you choose the room. These kids stay with me. Anna, Sophia, Amoy, Lauren, and Dalmir. Thanks. Bye-bye. See you guys at 10.